everybody. I'm Leslie. When you get up in the morning, do you ever think to yourself, ugh, what am I going to wear today? I know I do. The things we choose to wear can say a lot about us, about our environment, and even about our mood. Some things are functional, like eyeglasses. Others might be decorative, such as jewelry. And still others might be an expression of our interests and our connections. If it's a sunny day, I know I'm going to choose some sunglasses to go out. And if I'm going to a friend's house, I might choose to wear a friendship bracelet that they've made. And if I'm going to go play softball, I'm definitely going to put on my tennis shoes. Think about the things that you wear each day, such as clothing, jewelry, and shoes. What do those things say about you? Are they clues to who you are and what you enjoy? Today, educators from the Art Museum will help us explore ancient treasures that were meant to be worn. Are you ready for an art quest?
Hi, everyone. My name is Lisa, and I'm happy to be here today. Feel free to pause this video at any time to take a longer look at the art, gather materials, or talk with the people you're with. Today, we're going to explore three works of art that come from different cultures and represent artistic processes that have been around for centuries. Let's go! Let's take a moment to observe this work of art. This gold frog has a head shaped like a triangle and an oval-shaped body. Its hind legs stick out above rectangular paddle-like feet. The frog has bulging eyes and a line for a mouth. Ornate, wavy lines with a few spirals attached spring from the frog's mouth. This object is a pendant made of gold in Central America over 500 years ago. A pendant is a hanging ornament meant to be worn. Although we do not know exactly how this frog pendant was worn, we do know that gold objects like this were made for and worn by powerful, wealthy people. Fine objects of gold were made for rituals and special occasions rather than for daily use. The ancient peoples of what is today Panama and Costa Rica were known for their craftsmanship of fine gold objects. Frogs are one of the creatures often represented in the gold work of the ancient Americas. They were revered for their ability to live on land as well as water. Panama and Costa Rica are home to a colorful variety of both harmless and poisonous frogs. Imagine you have a pet frog. Draw a picture or write a description about your frog and its environment. You can share details about your frog and its home with the people you are with. If you like, you can pause the video now to do this activity, or you can do it later. A lotus flower surrounded by waves is featured front and center on this crown. Delicate lines on the lotus and the waves suggest texture and movement. A large flaming jewel rises above the lotus flower. A dragon sits on either side of the lotus flower and the jewel. This bronze crown was made in China around 900 to 1,000 years ago. Many of the fine details were created using a method called repoussé. Repoussé comes from the French language and means to push forward. The parts of the design that appear raised up were punched or hammered from the back of the object using very delicate tools. More details were added to the front by carving or etching into the metal. Let's look closer to find more details. Thousands of tiny scales were hammered individually to create the textured skin of the dragons.
curving grapevines create decorative borders at the top and bottom of the crown. A pattern that looks like a strand of gold beads flows alongside the grapevines. There are so many intricate details. Take a few moments to draw your favorite part of the crown. Look closely at the design on this disc. What can you discover? Describe what you see. A fierce beast with wolf-like facial features fills the space. The beast shows its sharp teeth and flashes its tongue out like a flame from a fire. The body of the beast is like a galloping horse. Its legs end in large, three-talon claws. The tail curves along the back of the creature and ends in the form of a serpent's head with large ears. This bronze disc is over 1,500 years old and was made in Europe as part of a set of body armor or a shield. Bronze was often used to make armor, tools, and weapons because it is a strong metal. Armor decorations like this one were probably originally painted in bright colors to help scare enemy soldiers. These three works of art have some things in common. All three feature animals or creatures and were made for and worn by powerful people. We invite you to visit slam.org to learn more about these and many other works of art in the museum's collection.
Hi, my name is Prathima, and I'm going to demonstrate how to make a requisite pendant. Let's use our observations from the three works of art we just explored to inspire our own art making.
What kind of creature will you create? Think about the details and the textures you want to add. Do you have all the supplies you need? Great! Let's get started. Take a small piece of white paper that's between 4 inches and 6 inches wide and long. Sketch an outline of your creature on the paper. Now fill in your outline with any details you want to add, such as eyes, feathers, fur, hooves or claws, a beak, whatever you imagine. Take a piece of aluminum foil that is at least 12 inches long. Make a hamburger fold at 4 inches and then again at 8 inches to form a trifold or threefold. Now, you should have a piece of aluminum foil roughly 4 by 6 inches. Place the animal drawing on top of the aluminum foil. If you like, you can use paper clips to hold your drawing in place as you trace. It will be helpful to have a pad of paper or a magazine underneath the foil. The cushioning will allow for all your trace details to show. Trace your animal using a dull pencil or a pen, gently pushing down on the foil as you trace. Be sure to trace all the details. Turn over the foil to see your creature. Do you notice how the lines pressed in from the back as you traced your creature look raised? That's repoussé art. If you would like to wear your repoussé creature as a pendant, punch a hole in the top center of your finished work. Cut a piece of yarn or string and thread it through the hole and tie the ends. Your artwork is now ready to be worn as a pendant. Here are two different ways you can make your creature pendant. This one has a creature inside a rectangle and can be hung on the wall if you choose not to wear it. And this one was cut in the shape of the creature and can be worn as a pendant. We would love to see what you make. Please share your creations on social media by using the hashtags STL Art Museum and Slam ArtQuest. Thank you for joining us today. Keep exploring and making art, and we hope you will visit the museum soon.